Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. I want to share with you this sweet and spicy Chipotle chili that I made. It is so good. It's wonderful for a cold evening, or if you're just sick and tired of eating cold food and you need something warm in your belly. It will hit all the spaces on your taste buds: the salty, the spicy, the sweet, and the sour. It hits them all and it hits the spot. I really love this chili. And I have a special ingredient in this chili that helps to lower blood sugar if you are struggling with blood sugar issues. So if you'd like to see how I make this soup, please stay tuned. But next we're gonna look at spices just a little bit. I'm gonna tell you exactly which spices I put in this chili and exactly how much. It'll be in a link in the description below so you can get all of it. But what I want to say here is most people fail on their healthy eating program because their food just tastes bland and it just doesn't taste good. It's because we grow up and we learn how to cook a certain way and we don't use herbs and spices that are going to add variety to our foods so that we could bring flavors into our foods so they don't taste disgusting. The bottom line is healthy foods in general are just not going to taste like the unhealthy foods. So what we have to do is train our taste buds for one and use herbs and spices in order to cause our food to taste much better. But first we're going to start with a pot. I just have a plain pot and I'm going to start with the vegetables, but I'm going to put some water in the pot and that's what I'm going to use to start to saute my vegetables. And everybody always says to me, well, Chelsea, if I don't use oil, what am I going to use? Well, water. Water, vegetable broth, vegetable juice, whatever you want to use to flavor or saute your vegetables. In this instance, I used water, and most of the time when I cook, that's what I use. And I put seasonings in my food, like we just showed you in the last clip, to make the flavor come out. You do not need oil to make flavor in your food. Frying food with oil is carcinogenic. It causes cancer. You should not fry your food. I don't care if you're not frying it heavy. You just should not cook with oil. It's not good. So what I have here is about a half of a chopped white onion, a half of an orange bell pepper, a half of a green bell pepper, and I chopped about 6 or 7 shiitake mushrooms. And what I'm gonna do here is just let them get a little hot in the pan. You see how the water is starting to bubble up? And I'm just gonna saute them around. And if any point when you're sauteing your vegetables in water and it starts to stick to the pan, all you have to do is add more water. And now I'm gonna add some zucchini. I have one zucchini that I chopped here. I'm just adding that to the pan. And I chopped about a quarter of a head of celery here, and I chopped it very small. You can have big chunks in your chili if you would like. I just wanted mine small. And really what I wanted that for is to give it a more of a like a salty taste, because I didn't want to add salt. You guys know that I only add salt to my food if I absolutely have to. But other than that, I use pink Himalayan crystal salt. Sometimes I use Celtic sea salt. I think that is very important not to use what they call sea salt in the store, because that's just basic table salt. So you want to find mineral salts, which are Himalayan pink salt, gray salt, red salt, Celtic sea salt. You get the picture. So next I'm going to add 1 can of organic diced tomatoes. If you're going to use diced tomatoes, try to use the organic variety, because tomatoes is one of those crops that are heavily sprayed. There are some that you can buy that are pretty inexpensive. Like I get a case from Costco, a case of 8 of them for like $6 or $7, and I think that's a good price. And next I'm gonna add 2 cans of tomato sauce. So that's what's really gonna be the base of this chili. And, well, base and body of the chili. So you see I added 1 can and it looks like I'm gonna need another can, so that's why I'm adding 2. And so we let that heat through a little bit and then we're going to add our beans, our red beans. You can really add whichever kind of beans you like. I wanted red kidney beans because I wanted this to be like your traditional chili. So, but you can use whatever you want. You can use a mix of beans. I just wanted red beans. So stir those through. Now we're going to get with those spices that we talked about earlier. Really, it's about 1 teaspoon of chipotle powder, 1 teaspoon of coriander or cumin, 1 vegetable bouillon cube, 1/4 to 1/2 teaspoon of cinnamon. That is the secret ingredient. That is the thing that helps to lower blood sugar. And 1/2 tablespoon of garlic. You can really use as much garlic as you want. And I have 1 teaspoon of parsley and 1/2 tablespoon of thyme. And be sure to adjust these seasonings for your taste buds. You might want more, and you might want more chipotle. You might want it spicier, or you might not want it as spicy as I have it. Just experiment and test the spices to your liking. That's how you learn how to be a good cook with healthy foods. A lot of people are healthy food cooks with the unhealthy foods that they grew up on and have no idea how to cook healthy foods. You can learn how to be a good cook for the healthy food. So just want to tell you that. I'm tasting it now, as you can tell, and this turned out wonderfully. My husband tore this up. I did too, and there was nothing left. So it's really good. So you let this heat through a little bit more. You don't want to cook it too long because you want your vegetables to be a little crunchy. But the last thing you do is add the other secret ingredient is avocado. This is 1 whole avocado chopped. And the reason I like using avocados in these soups is because the way it is, it's very, very low fat. And you want the fat in the soup to actually make you feel like you're getting something sticking to your ribs. So you might say, ew, avocado. Well, the thing about avocado is it takes on the flavor of whatever you add it to. So when you eat this soup, it's gonna taste like the spices in this soup. You're not even gonna taste the avocado. You're gonna taste the body that the avocado adds to the soup, like the heaviness that the heaviness of the avocado's fat in the soup. That's what you're gonna taste. I hope that makes sense. But I let this heat through, bring it to a boil, and really all I'm gonna do now is serve it and eat it. So if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with a friend. Don't forget to subscribe. And thank you so much for all your love and support. And I will talk to you all soon. Take care.